Good morning, students. You are welcome on the day Friday, 21st of August 2020, class physics, 10th to 11th, unit 22, electromagnetic induction, and topic is solve example 22.1. On this page, a one example is given. A figure is shown on the book. On page 2429 at the top. Figure is like this. There is one solenoid and one Bohr magnet is there. Now, while the magnet moves inside and moves outward, three cases we have to discuss that what will be happen regarding EMF, electromagnetic flux. In the first figure, while magnet moves, of course number of line of magnetic forces will enter in solenoid. Its name, the flux, electromagnetic flux of solenoid will be changed. And we have studied about the Lenz's law, that when electromagnetic flux is being changed, EMF, electromotive force, will be produced. Why? Electromagnetic flux is being changed, the number of lines of magnet field of Bohr magnet passing through the solenoid, that will be changed. And due to this change, we call change of electromagnetic flux. So while the electromagnetic flux will change, EMF will be produced. And here, galvanometer needle will be deflect on the right one. Arrow shows the movement of the magnet is from right to left. And if you observe keenly, you can see that the current is moving from here and rotating like this one, from down to upward, from down to upward, and it leaves on from this end. And we have studied the fourth peak of the Lenz's law experiments. While the north pole of the magnet moves toward the solenoid, the direction of the current produced, or the EMF, will be opposite to that of the direction of the magnet movement. Magnet is moving from right to left. The current is moving from left to right. So here, the peak EMF will be produced. We have already studied that how we can improve the value of EMF by increasing the strength of the magnet, by increasing the number of turn of the coil, and thirdly, by increasing the relative motion of the magnet. If the magnet will be moved very fastly, of course the peak of the EMF will be there. So here, positive peak of the EMF will be produced. Now, while in the second figure, while the magnet is inside moving, but it is still inside the coil, what will be the result? Of course, there will be a constant electromagnetic flux. no change in electromagnetic flux, and this is the reason that when flux remain constant, EMF will be zero. No EMF. Why? Because there is no change in the flux. We have studied according to the Lenz's law, unless the electromagnetic flux is being changed, EMF will not be produced. Only the condition is this, that electromagnetic flux changes. If no change, zero EMF. Even the magnet is away from the coil and no magnet line of forces being passes through the solenoid, even then the EMF will be zero. No EMF will be induced. Or it comes here inside the, it remains constant, no motion. Even then there will be no electromagnetic flux and no EMF. And thirdly, it is inside the coil moving, but in the same that no change of the flux. Flux is there, but not changing. Flux is there, but it is constant. Therefore, because of the constant EMF, no constant flux, there will be no EMF. And now, zero EMF. Lastly, the third figure. If we see that now, bar magnet is going to leave, almost leaving this. Again, there will be a change of flux. But in this case, negative peak, negative flux will be. In the first case, while it moves toward, that was a peak, positive EMF. And now it is leaving the solenoid. Therefore, negative EMF, negative peak of the EMF will be there. So, as the magnet leaving the coil, again the flux will be changed and EMF will be produced. So, in this case, as it is leaving, south pole of the magnet is leaving the solenoid, this end of the coil will acquire a north pole. So, if we see the last figure, that is graph. First, zero EMF. Theta represent the deflection of galvanometer. Deflection versus time. Deflection versus time. Here it is time. This direction of time. So this graph is deflection of needle of galvanometer against the time. Now here, while the magnet was outside, zero EMF. While it started moving toward the coil or solenoid, the peak EMF was there. And while it was moving inside this area represents the constant constant flux, electromagnetic flux. Therefore, due to the constant electromagnetic flux, there was no change in the flux, there was no EMF was induced. And now from here, this point, the last third figure, now the magnet is again leaving the coil or the solenoid. Therefore, again, the magnet field will be changed. Again, the electromagnetic flux will be changed, and again, EMF will be induced. But in this case, firstly, while the magnet was moving toward, that was a positive peak, and now while in the third figure, While the magnet is leaving, the negative peak of the EMF will be produced. So this will be called positive half and this will be called a negative half. Thank you. God bless you, boy. Hopefully you have understand. This was very critical article and I tried my best to make it well understand. If you have any question, please, you can ask me on phone, my phone, or through the WhatsApp of your O-level group. Again, God bless you. Have a very wonderful day.